Huge crowd once again at the Monona Terrace. They were loud and cheering for their guy and never got louder than it did than for our next guest right now, who, by the way, is enjoying himself after a big win. Mark Lemminger is joining us right now. And Mark, yeah, it seems like you got some libations to help you celebrate your victory there. What are you drinking there?
Some whiskey donated by Joshua Sterry himself. He gave it to us right before we got here.
So. Beautiful. I love it.
Bottle's going to be gone by the end of the day.
Nice. And of course, for TV purposes, it's only a prop. That's what we're going to say right there. But you should be celebrating. Hey, you got back into the winning spirit after starting off at 7-0 on your career. You faced the Vanilla Gorilla and went down in that one, but you got back onto the winning side of things. How did that feel?
Felt great. Felt good to get back in the winning side of things. Get on that W column again, you know?
Yeah, absolutely. And talk about your fight then, if you will, because Rocky Edwards seemed like a pretty game fighter. And, you know, he was trying to get you there for a while. He just didn't roll over and die on you. But it seemed like you had your groove back. You were right back to that place where you like to be, and that's like fighting right next to a guy, not letting him breathe.
Yeah. That's how you had to be with a guy like him. Took me a little bit, you know, it's been a while since I've been in the cage, so it took me a little bit to feel it out. But started to pick up a little bit in the second and third round, figured out, got it done.
Yeah, you sure did. One thing that we commented about is that you seemed so comfortable, though, there, especially once the second round started. So when you were in top position and controlling him, you even a couple times would just stop, look over at Damian DeCora in your corner, get some instruction, and go right back to what you're doing. Were you that comfortable in the cage last night?
Yeah, we got in a couple kind of stalemate positions where he was trying to lock something up and it wasn't gonna happen, but I couldn't really get out of it. So it was kind of a stalemate in a few times during that fight. So yeah, I could look over at my corners. Yeah, it was relaxed. It was a relaxed fight for
Yeah, I even saw you at the end of the first round, you're taking a look at the screen up above. Now, do you do that to look at the clock when you're looking at the big screen?
Yeah. Sometimes I'm looking at the clock. Other times, if I'm cut once in a while, I'll look up there to see where the cut is.
Okay.
If I'm in a situation where I can do that, but it's a bad habit. I should probably work on
it. That's how you do it. I'm wondering if you're looking at position, because you can kind of get sometimes a reverse angle and see it.
Yeah, sometimes you do. But for the most part, I'm just kind of seeing what I got left in the round, looking at, seeing if I'm cut in certain places. But I don't know. It's something my coaches yell at me about.
I'm actually glad that our coverage is good enough that you could utilize it while you're in the moment there like that. So what I think is cool and what I think is great for you guys, and one reason to celebrate for you, is that the Chosen Few represented themselves really well last night. Talk about, I mean, how good that has to feel to be part of a gym that has such great success.
Oh, man, we got killers in there. And everybody, they work so hard. We work hard together. We got such a solid team there. I could not ask for better teammates. That's one thing that I'm so grateful for.
Yeah, one of those teammates that is back off the road a little bit. We got to see him was Alex Gilpin, who was hanging out there last night. You know, if you could, is his success something that you would hope to mirror where, you know, eventually you're on the road like that as well?
Yeah, you said it perfectly. I try to mirror a lot of things he does because he's on that next level, and I think a lot of the guys do. We all kind of look at him, and we're trying to get on that level with him, you know?
Yeah, I think you guys are going to get there. I mean, Dante's been on fire. Yeah. Alex has been, I mean, just going off, and nobody wants to fight him, and I think you're on that level, too. So what's next? Is it a January card that we got coming up next?
I think February is February, the next Madison one. I'm open for anything. I want to kind of get back in there right away. I'm feeling good, injury-free for once after this fight, so I want to get back in there as soon as I can. Whether it be in Madison or somewhere else, I don't really care.
Yeah, the face is looking good after a fight
for
you.
Change,
yes. Hey, congratulations to you, Mark, and cheers.
Yeah, thanks, guys.
Brought to you by Konin Automotive, taking care of you by taking care of your family's car.